take-home salary for the employees and also to give relief to employers in the payment of PF for those which have not been covered under the earlier description, which is if you have 100 employees, 90% of whom are drawing less than 15,000, we announced a scheme earlier, which I'm extending for another 3 months. That's what was announced a minute ago. The second one in EPF now is the statutory PF contribution for those who are not covered in the earlier one is being reduced from 12% to 10%. So for the next 3 months, employers need to pay only 10% and not 12% so that they will have some more money in their hands. However, for the central public sector enterprises and for state PSUs, we will continue to pay 12%. So this reduction is not for the government. However, government employees, government employer still pays 12%. But employees in these public sector undertakings will be given the advantage of paying only 10%. So a liquidity relief of 6,750 crores for both the employee and employer will be available for the next 3 months.
एक और प्रावधान, क्योंकि आज के समय पैसा कर्मचारी के हाथ में भी कैसे ज्यादा हो, इसमें भी एक बड़ी राहत देने का प्रयास इसमें किया है कि जो ईपीएफ कंट्रीब्यूशन है, जिनका ईपीएफ का योगदान है, वो ऐसे संस्थानों के लिए और कर्मचारियों के लिए 12-12% से कम करके 10-10% अगले 3 महीनों के लिए किया गया है। इससे कर्मचारी भी और संस्थान दोनों को लाभ मिलेगा, लेकिन जो सरकारी हमारी संस्थान है, सेंट्रल पीएससीज हैं, इनके लिए 12-12% ही रहेगा, उसमें कोई बदलाव नहीं किया गया है। तो इससे कुल मिलाकर 6,750 करोड़ रुपए का लिक्विडिटी सपोर्ट इनको मिलेगा और एक तरह से 6,750 करोड़ रुपया ज्यादा इनके हाथ में आएगा।
The next one is about non-banking financial companies, housing finance corporations and microfinance institutions. We have been hearing, in spite of a lot of steps which the RBI took, in spite of all the provisions that we made between the July budget and February budget, it was felt that the NBFCs were not able to get enough resources. And particularly,